Good morning everyone, myself is Girish Sriyas, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Cambridge Institute of Technology, KRPuram, Bangalore. In this video, we are going to discuss about advantages, disadvantages and application of metal forming.
Next, what are the advantages of metal working process or metal forming process? Okay, so in metal working process, you can give a necessary useful shape to the metal. Almost a final shape can be achieved. So you have a open die forming and closed die forming. With the use of closed die forming, closed to the dimension, okay, required dimensional accuracy will be achieved. So as we know, in order to deform bulk material, we have to use the hot working process. Hot working, you will not get a good surface finish. So that allowance will be provided. The finished product is having some size, okay, 5% more than that, 5% or allowance will be provided for machining after forming. So if you do the machining process, you can increase the surface finish of the component. So with the help of metal forming, you can achieve near to the final product shape. You can achieve many process produce directly finished product, okay, as in the cold working process, because the surface finish is good, okay, we'll get a finished product directly, okay. So reduction as much as possible you carry out with hard working process. Only at the final stage of sheet reduction you can switch on to the cold working process, so that finishing will be good. So as we know, because of deformation, all the impurities will be minimized. Whatever the casting impurities left in the material, okay, even though if you take necessary action or regular monitoring of the casting process, casting defects are bound to occur. Cannot eliminate into zero defect model. There are small defects to be there. In order to eliminate those defects, the metal forming process eliminate defects like porosity, crack and all. Okay, because of compressing, the surface, the defects will become close to each other and it will be removed from the material. Okay, so next, product with consistent high quality can be manufacturing. Okay, so as we see, in the hot working process, you can produce a isotropic property of the material. Property are same in all the directions. So the mechanical property will be enhanced. Okay, so compared to as cast material and product of forming process, the because of the grain orientation, grain structure will change. Okay, so when you do the casting process, depending upon the way you will cooling the solidification take place, okay, if you allow to cool slowly, very slowly, a small grain structure will be obtained. If you do sudden cooling, the grain structure will be more. Okay, so even when the grain structure is more, sudden cooling brings the hardness into the material. When the grain sides are more, it will become hard. Okay, so if you do the heat treatment and further deform with the application of force, the grains will reduce into smaller size, so that we can enhance the mechanical property. Okay, so defects such as porosity and discontinuities are minimized with the help of forming process. So grains are oriented in particular direction and the directional properties are obtained. So in whichever direction you require the property will get. For example, hook. So hook is used to lift the heavy weight. It is a small component only. Okay. Where bending stresses are applied on the hook section. Okay. You will do the forging process for producing the hook, so that on the required direction you can orient the grains and produce greater strength onto the hook. So if you produce the hook through normal casting process, the grains alignment will be horizontal only. Okay, so here in forging operation, hook is having a C shape, having a C curved shape. So the grains will be oriented in that direction only. See, direction, curved grains you will get. So if you do normal for casting process, you will get horizontal grind. So it will easily break. As I told you, along the grains, properties will be more. Across the grains, property will be less. If you do casted component of hook, grains will be horizontal direction. So the force that will act across the grain, and then the hook will be broken. Okay. So in the forging operation, we bend the hook material or raw material into C shape, so that grains will be oriented in C direction only. Okay. So whatever the force will be applied on the hook to lift the heavy weight, it is applied on the along the grains only, not across the grain. Okay. If you are manufacturing hook in normal casting, so the force will be applied across the grains and it will easily break. Okay. If you are manufacturing hook through metal forming, the grain orientation will be in curved shape only, so that the stresses will be applied in the horizontal grain oriented direction only. The forces will be applied on the grain oriented direction only, so that it can be withstand high resistance in and it can easily lift the heavy weight. Okay. So in hot working, the grains will be uniform and properties are also uniform. In cold working, properties are enhanced due to strain hardening effect, and also good surface will be obtained. Okay, when if you want good surface, so you have to go for cold work. A large tonnage can be easily produced. A large component size can be easily deformed through metal forming process. The process can be easily mechanized. The process will carry out. Okay, large section material, large component, how it is reduced into smaller cross section strips, aluminium strips. For framework and all, you see aluminium strips. It is produced in a Jindal aluminium factory in Tumkur Road, Bangalore. All of you seen that factory. So there, the aluminium extrusion will be carried out. Aluminium extrusion means you will get a uniform cross section bars. Okay. Aluminium rolling unit is there in Dabas Pete. Dabas Pete hard cast material and does not have good property. Okay. So you can enhance the mechanical property through metal forming process, and you can get the directional property as I gave the example of hook. Okay, if you manufacturing hook through normal casting, grains will be oriented in horizontal direction. In all the sections of hook, grains are horizontal only. Okay, so that when you try to lift the load from the hook, hook will break. Okay, the failure will take place because force will be acting across the grain, failure will occur. So if you manufacturing hook through forging operation, grains will be oriented in curved fashion. How the hook will be having curved section, and same fashion the grains will be oriented, so that when you are lifting, the force will be acting along the grain. Okay, you have to see that you have to orient the grain so that forces will be acting along the grain only, so that its strength will be increased. Okay. Similarly, if you can see the application of metal forming process, manufacturing of hook, manufacturing of rail wheels, okay, manufacturing of rails, okay, you see the railway tracks are also manufacturing by forging only. It has to absorb lot of load. Okay, after forging, after producing railway tracks, it has to possess a toughness and ductile property. Okay, ductile as well as it is having tensile strength. It should not deform. The rails should not be deformed because of the load, but it should have toughness property because it has to absorb shocks and loads. Okay, without breaking. Toughness property should be there, and it should be having enough strength. Okay, rails and rail wheels connecting around also manufacturing by metal forming. TMT bars for manufacturing in construction purpose. What we see TMT bars in all construction purpose use TMT bars in manufacturing in construction of houses, columns and beams, then bridges, structures. Okay, all this are metal forming applications only. TMT means thermo mechanically treated. Okay, thermo means your subject, metal is subjected to heating. Mechanically means you apply forces, okay, and you produce the component. The TMT bars are produced with the help of extrusion process or drying process. Okay, so we'll discuss the process in detail. Okay, following slide. The next limitation of mechanical working. Sometimes cold working, the product becomes highly anisotropic in nature. As we discuss, cold working produces a property different in different direction. Those associated with the cold working reduce the ductility and induce brittleness of the metal. In cold working, strain hardening is the major problem. Because of cold working, the metal will become hard and brittle. Okay, ductility will not remain in the material. To carry out metal working process, it require additional heavy equipments and machinery for metal working process. In order to apply the forces in particular direction, in order to rotate the rollers and with more force, so you require lot of machineries. Hence, the initial investment is very high. So a series of roller has to be set up. Okay, in a large room, as I told you. The unit size is around 400 meter, as I see in this W. Bellary steel sheet manufacturing. A series of roller, along with in between that roller, you have to keep the heating chamber. So in order to, the lot of electricity required, lot of motors required, okay, to run the equipment and all. Okay, it involves lot of initial investment cost. Okay. And also maintenance cost is high. This machinery also undergo maintenance frequently, so that initial cost and maintenance cost is high. More safety precaution are to be exercised as hard metals and additional equipments are used. Because of use of the hard metals, so you have to take your more precautionary measures. These are the disadvantages of metal working process. Okay.
In this video, we discuss about advantages, disadvantages, and application of metal forming process. Hope you all understand. Thank you for watching. Have a good day.